Hey guys, what's happening? My name's Cal, and in today's Java and Android Studio tutorial, we're going to be building a weekly calendar view. More specifically, we're going to be converting our monthly calendar view, which we built in our previous tutorial, and turning it into a weekly calendar view. Then in the next part of the video, we're going to be building an ability to add events to our calendar view, so you can scroll through each day and it'll show you a different list of events. Cool, so picking back up from where we left off last time, I'm just going to clone our calendar tutorial Android Studio project from GitHub, and I'm just renaming it to a directory calling it weekly calendar tutorial. And first thing we're going to do is just create a couple of activities. So just same file, new empty activity. I'm calling the first one week view activity, and then same thing. So file, new activity, and I'm going to call this one event edit activity. Finally, we're going to create a layout resource file. I'm just calling it event cell, and its root element is going to be a linear layout. And then we're going to head into our main XML. We're just going to create a button to link to our weekly view. So I'm just going to copy and paste this top button here, changing the width to wrap content, getting rid of the weight, layout gravity is equal to center, and just changing the text to weekly. Our on click is going to be our weekly action, and we're just going to create that in our main activity.java. At our weekly action function, we're just going to call start activity, giving it a new intent, context of this, and our week view activity class. Next, what we're going to do is head in and copy and paste everything that's in our main activity XML, and we're just going to hit command A and paste that into our activity week view XML. We're just going to change the context to our week view activity as well. We're going to get rid of that button because obviously we don't need that. And then you can see we've got an error message here on our on click. So I'm just going to rename this to previous week action, as well as our next button to our next week action. And I'm just going to create both of those in our week view activity. Then I'm going to scroll right down to the bottom. I'm going to change our recycler view height to 0 dp, as well as giving it a weight of 1. And then I'm going to copy and paste in another button below our recycler view. I'm going to change the width to wrap content, get rid of the weight, and set the text to new event. We're going to make the onClick new event action and just create that function in our week view activity. We're going to set the layout gravity to center. And below that, we're going to insert a list view. We're going to give it a width of match parent, height 0 dp, and a weight of 5. So that's going to be our event list view. Next, I'm going to create a Java class calling it calendar utils. And what we're going to do is just copy and paste a few things out of our main activity and put them in our calendar utils, mainly because we're going to use them in multiple activities within our app. So I'm just changing our selected date to be a public and static variable. And as a result of that, all of the references to selected date, we just need to say calendar utils and give it a dot before our selected date. So I'm just copy and pasting that in all of those instances. We're also going to change our days in month array to be public and static, as well as changing our month year from date. That's going to be public and static. We're going to put that in our calendar utils file as well. And if we read that error message, it's just saying press Alt Enter to import that function from our calendar utils. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to hit Alt Enter. And then we're going to copy and paste from our week view activity. We're going to copy our init widgets function, as well as our set month view, as well as the text view and recycler view. So I'm going to change our set month view to be set week view. I'm going to copy and paste what's in our on item click and just make sure that our week view implements our calendar adapter on item listener. And we obviously don't need the if day text is equal to 0. So I'm just going to remove that. And then we're also going to pull out what's happening in our previous month action and put that into our previous week action. And just obviously changing the selected date to minus weeks one and our set week view instead of our set month view. And then we're just going to copy and paste that down into our next week action and making that plus weeks. Next, we're going to create a function calling it days in week array. And we're going to put that in our calendar utils as well. So that needs to be public and static. I'm just going to put the month from year date above our days in month array. So yeah, making our days and week array public and static. And we just hit Alt Enter in our week view activity to import that function. We're going to rename our array to days, as well as making our array list of type local date as opposed to a string. We're changing the type of array list that we're passing into our calendar adapter because we're going to make our selected date have a different background color. And it's easy to determine that by passing in the whole local date as opposed to the day of month as a string. Changing the variable name to days as opposed to day of month because we're going to have a weekly view. So rather than have it day of month or day of week, we're just going to call it days. Cool. And inside our onBind view holder, we're going to just extract our days.getPosition to a local variable. So it's going to be a local date, calling it date. And in our set text, we're going to say date get day of month. We can head back into our calendar utils and finish off our days and week array. Obviously, it needs to return an array list of local date, as well our days and month function. And where we're adding an empty string, we're going to add null. And for our else statement, we're going to say local date of selected date.getYear, giving it a comma, selected date.getMonth, and then our I minus day of week. Cool, we can copy down our array list of local dates and just renaming that to days. We're gonna return our days at the bottom of our days and week array function. Then we're gonna declare a local date calling it current is equal to Sunday for date. and passing it in our selected date. And then I'm going to create that function. It's a private static function. I'm going to rename the local date to current. Well, declare one more local date, calling it 1 week ago, which is equal to our current minus 1 week. We're going to create a while loop. So while current is after 1 week ago, if our current get day of week is equal to our day of week of Sunday. So if the day of week is Sunday, return current, meaning return the Sunday. Otherwise, current is equal to current minus 1 days. And then if you can't find a Sunday, which will never happen, we're going to return null. So basically, look a week into the past, go backwards until you find Sunday. Cool. And in our days and week array below our current, we're going to declare another local date. We're going to call it end date is equal to current plus weeks one. And then we're going to say while current is before our end date, days.addCurrent, current is equal to current plus days one. And then we're just going to return our days.
Cool. And we're just going to head back into our week view activity, command click or control click to go into our calendar adapter. And then we're going to say if days size is greater than 15, so meaning that it's our month view, we're just going to do exactly what we've already been doing. Otherwise, if it's our week view, we're going to set our layout params equal to our parent height. Cool. And if we scroll down just a little bit in our onBind view holder, we just need to say if date is equal to null, we're going to set our holder day of month, set our text to be this empty string. Otherwise, we're going to set it to our date.getDayOfMonth. And then also inside this else statement, we're going to check to see if our date is equal to our selected date. We just need to go in and change our calendar cell to have an ID. So we're going to give our constraint layer an ID of parent view. And then I'm going to copy and paste that ID, head into our calendar view view holder, declare it here, just calling public final view, parent view. And I've gone about this the long way. You don't need to add this field to the constructor. And we just need to find that view by item view, find view by ID, r.id, parent view. Cool. And now we can set our parent view background color to light gray. And back inside our calendar adapter, we just need to say string.value of our date.getDayOfMonth.
Cool. And if we build and run this and have a look at our weekly calendar view, we can scroll through the weeks and it all seems to be updating correctly. However, when we select on one of the days, it's still showing our toast and we'd rather it highlight our selected date. Heading into our calendar adapter, I'm just going to copy our array list of days and I'm going to paste that into our calendar view holder. And then in our constructor, I'm going to add our days. This days is equal to days. And then our on item click is going to receive a local date of our days.get at position. And then we're going to head in and change our interface to be a local date. And we're just going to rename that variable to date. Now we're going to have some error messages. So we're going to go in and add that. So we're just going to pass through our days array. We're also going to change this to a local date, just renaming it date. Call calendar utils selected date is equal to date and then say set week view from our on item click. And we're going to do the same thing in our main activity. So just copy and pasting that whole on item click function and then just changing that to set month view. And then in our month view, we just need to check that it's not null because we'll have the days before and after the month. And if we build and run this again, when you select on a date, we're highlighting the correct selected date. So that all is looking really good. So what we're going to do is flesh out our events. So we're going to have the ability to create a new event and then we're going to show it in our list view. So the first thing we're going to do is close off a few of the different things because we're done with those. And we're just going to head into our new event action. We're going to call start activity, giving a new event, context of this, and our edit event activity. Now we're going to get our layout sorted. So we're just going to set the orientation of this layout to vertical. We're going to add in a text view, giving it a height and width of wrap content. We're going to say layout gravity is equal to center and margin top 20 dp, as well as text size is 20 sp, text alignment center, and our text color is going to be black. And the reason why our layout gravity wasn't working is I actually need to make this parent layout a linear layout. And then below our text view, we're going to add in an edit text. So wrap content on the height and width, layout gravity center as well, text size 20 sp, EMS is going to be 10, so that's how wide it is. Our input type is going to be text, and I'm just going to give it an ID calling it event name edit text. And then we're going to copy and paste down our text view twice more, and I'm going to change this to date as well as time. And so basically, just of keeping this tutorial brief, I'm not actually going to implement a date picker or a time picker, but if I was really building this app, I would totally use a pop-up time picker and a pop-up date picker. I've already created videos on both of those, so I didn't feel the need to sort of double up. But yeah, I'll be sure to leave a link in the description to both of those videos if you did want to implement a date and a time picker. Below those text views though, I'm just going to implement a button. So I'm just going to steal the one from our new event. I'm just going to copy and paste that below. Just change the text to save and the onClick to save event action, and then create that function in our Java class. I'm going to give it a little bit more margin to the top, so 20 dp. And then I'm going to head into our edit event activity. I'm just going to declare all of those widgets, so our edit text as well as our two text views. Create the familiar init widget function, which just finds all of those views by their ID. I'm going to declare a local time, just calling it time.
And then I'm going to initialize it to be local time now. So we want to set our event date text view to be the date that the user selected. So I'm just going to say set text is equal to date plus calendar utils dot formatted date, passing it in our selected date. And then we just need to create that function in our calendar utils. I'm just going to copy and paste and put it at the top. And then we're going to copy our month year from date, and then just changing our date pattern to include the days. And then I'm gonna copy and paste that function again and just call it formatted time. And instead of being a local date, we're gonna change it to local time and changing the variable name to time. And then we're just going to say our date formatted pattern is equal to hours, minutes, seconds, and then little a is the AM, PM. And then we can duplicate that line, changing it to time as well as our event time text view, and then just calling our formatted time and giving it our time that we just created. And then I'm going to right click, I'm going to create one more Java class. I'm going to call it event, and it's just going to be a public class. It's going to have a string name, a local date, date, and a local time, time. And then I'm going to right click and generate getters and setters, as well as right click, generate a constructor that takes all of the fields. And then right at the top of the class, we're going to declare a public static array list of events, just calling it events list. And below that, we're going to create a function which returns all the events for a given date. So I'm just calling it events for date, and it receives a date. And then we're going to copy and paste down that events list just so we don't have to retype it, return that events. We're going to say for event in our event list, if our event date equals the date that's passed in, we're going to add that to our events. Cool. So now we can head into our edit event activity and we can create a string. We're going to call it event name is equal to event name dot get text to string. And then we can create a new event. We're just calling it new event is equal to new event. We're going to get our selected date as well as our time. We're going to add that to our events list and then just call finish to close the activity. Heading inside our week view activity, we're going to override the onResume function, create a function underneath it calling it setEventAdapter, and we're just going to create that method below. And then we're going to call our setEventAdapter from our setWeekView function. We're going to create a new Java class calling it eventAdapter. Our eventAdapter class is going to extend arrayAdapter of type event. And then we're going to right click and create the constructor. We're going to change that resource to a list of events, just calling it events. In our super, we're going to pass through 0 for our resource as well as our events. And then we're going to override the getView function. We're going to say event is equal to get item at position. If our convertView is equal to null, we're going to say convertView is equal to layout inflator from get context inflate our layout event cell. We're going to give it parent and attached to root is false. Cool, and now we can head in and actually do the layout for our event cell. We're just going to set the height to 60dp as well as adding in a text view. Width, height, wrap content, as well as giving it an ID event cell text view. Text size is going to be 20sp as well as changing the color to black. We're going to make the text event, and we're actually going to make the height match parent as well as the gravity center. We're going to give a little bit of margin to the start, so 20dp. I'm just going to copy that ID, head back into our get view. We're going to declare that text view, calling it event cell text view, calling convert view find view by ID. We're going to declare a new string calling it event title, which is equal to event get name plus a little bit of space. And then we're going to get our formatted time from our event time. We're going to call event cell text view set text with our event title and then just return the convert view. Back inside our set event adapter function, we can create an array list of events, just calling it daily events. We're just going to call our events for date, giving it our selected date. Our event adapter is equal to a new event adapter. We're going to pass it application context as well as our daily events. And then in our week view, we're just going to give our list view an ID. So just calling it event list view. Going to copy and paste that ID, declare that and find the view by its ID in our init widgets function. And then we can call that list view and just say set adapter, giving it our event adapter. Cool. If we build and run this again, you can see that we can create a new event. I'm just calling this one appointment and it's on the 1st of June. And you can see that's when we've got the 1st of June selected. It's showing in our list view correctly. I hope you found some value in this weekly calendar view tutorial. If you made it this far, consider giving the video a like and subscribing. But otherwise, I'll catch you guys in the next tutorial.